Do you want to build a content machine that will generate leads for your business every single day? If so, this episode of The Revenue Streams is for you. Hey, it's Rob Alsabis with the TubeBuddy team, and today we're talking with Diana Gladney about how she's using YouTube and videos to build her successful coaching and consulting business. We're gonna dig into content, systems, and processes that Diana's put into place to ensure her success. But first, Alex, welcome to the show. Glad to have you back with me for another episode. How are you doing?
Hey, Rob. Happy, what day is today? Happy Thursday. Super excited to be here. We're getting ready for Bit Summit 2021. Awesome. So, you know, very, very busy and interesting times, but, you know, super excited to talk to Diana today. So, really looking forward to this interview and video.
Diana, welcome to the show. How's it going?
I'm doing great. Thanks so much for having me, fellas.
Yeah, yeah. Glad to have you here. It's so awesome to catch up. So, let's just dive right into it, Alex. Why don't you get this thing kicked off?
Yeah, yeah. Well, you're not going to be surprised by the very first question we have, and that is, what are your different revenue streams from your content at the moment, right? Whether you have affiliate, sponsorships, all of that. Tell us a little bit more about it. You know, and it will be interesting to hear which one are your kind of like biggest streams versus your smaller ones, or your bigger focus versus the ones you focus at the very least.
For sure. So I'll kind of try to name them somewhat in order of that. So it would obviously be the coaching consulting that we do. We also have courses and products that we offer. We also have keynote speaking and just speaking gigs and stuff like that. We have sponsorship deals that are included with some of the content or some of the different things that we may be doing. Not necessarily always like a baked in ad or something for YouTube or what have you. And then you have like affiliate, merch, and any other kind of like revenue streams that are kind of more or less passive in that way. And then somewhere in the middle of there, I would put like the YouTube ad revenue and stuff like that somewhere about the middle.
That's awesome. That's awesome.
Got it. So Diana, where do you spend your most time in those revenue streams? Is it the coaching? Which is your main one in your opinion?
Yeah, so it definitely is the coaching and consulting business that we have and those clients. We do have a little bit of income still that's coming in from, you know, the tail end of some video editing production work. And so we still manage a little bit of that. But other than that, it's like that's the main focus and everything else kind of comes or trickle down after that.
Got it. And sorry, Rob, one more follow-up question.
Of course.
And can you tell us a little bit more about the focus of your coaching and the focus or your niche, if you want to describe that a little bit more?
Yeah, for sure. So my whole company, everything is about helping the entrepreneur simplify the video creation process, which means usually you have an entrepreneur, you're already efficient in your business, you know what you're doing there, and you know what you sell and what your products and services are, who your target audience is, and all those different things. But now you realize that you need to get into this content creation space. Now you're looking at stuff like the cameras, the microphone, live streaming, and all these other elements that may completely take you out of your element. And that's where our company comes in to help you understand the what you need to do and the how to do it when you start to get into the content creation space so that you can get back to the point of why you wanted to create the content to begin with just to serve your business. So that's where we come in with our business.
Awesome. Got it. Thank you so much.
Awesome. Awesome. Mm-hmm. Well, Diana, you're a content machine. I can't help but see you pretty much everywhere, not just on YouTube, but on Instagram, Instagram stories, LinkedIn, Facebook, and all of your posts are so on point and really bringing value every single time. So I've got a two-part question here. The first part is, where does this content fall into your funnel or your customer journey? And then the second is, how does this content help you generate coaching and consulting clients?
So I think with some people, they start off with micro content being some form of a pillar content. We don't. That's where our YouTube videos and stuff comes in, even like talks that we repurpose for speaking engagements and things like that. So the micro content comes underneath the main content. And with that, we usually have different goals for the what we're trying to do with it. And so that's usually the thing. It's that repurposed content coming from the pillar content to make sure that one, yeah, of course you are getting awareness and things like that, but even the micro content, everything that we produce has a job to do, and we can definitely dive into details, but like the what each piece is doing it's based on the role and stuff that we have designed for it to do. So we don't just produce something just for the sake of see us. We're producing something with that content in mind to do a specific job for our target audience.
Got it. So for example, Instagram stories versus LinkedIn posts, is that different? Is there a different intention mm-hmm. for you, like awareness yeah. versus, you know, getting them to download something or sign up for an email list?
So when somebody goes to a certain kind of medium of content, so you take a look at Instagram stories, they're going there to connect with you, the person, or they're looking to get some of that behind the scenes goodness. So they're not really going for you to promote and sell to them. Not that you can't, because you definitely can, and we do. But when you click on that profile, you've already seen some of the other stuff that the initial posts are doing. You've engaged, you've read captions, that what we call social behaviors. So when somebody's going through that content, that next social behavior for them to get to a connection level with you, they're going to click on the stories. So we show funny stuff, or we show, I'm going to buy this at the store, or what do you think is in this bag? Or here's something that I'm working on this week. Or if you didn't know this, here's something that you can do, whatever, because now they're getting more in tune with you, the person, you, the creator or entrepreneur or whatever your page is about. So for us, that's what we do there. And yes, we will speak about what we have going on because it just makes sense. But a LinkedIn post, more or less, again, what's the social behavior of that platform? Why is somebody, let's say, researching a hashtag or following you to begin with? And then now what kind of content do they expect? And that's what we produce based on their wants, needs and desires. And every platform, we work the same way.
That's so smart. Yeah, a lot of people don't recognize that. So, you know, because on Instagram stories, you've got skits and these are so hilarious. And so I always think like, okay, this is so brilliant because now they're getting to know Diana, they're getting to know your mm-hmm. humor. But then there's also this other side of you with LinkedIn and also your YouTube content and your live streams mm-hmm. where you're just straight out answering people's questions and you're building authority. Mm-hmm. So talk to us then a little bit about where does YouTube fall into all of this? Like what that YouTube piece, is that the most important? Is that sort of like the closing, I guess, in terms mm-hmm. of like where the bottom of the funnel, where does mm-hmm. that fall into place?
No, YouTube for us is our pillar content, which means it's at the very top of the what we're doing. Because initially when somebody is having a problem based on the stuff that we plan to serve, okay, well, where somebody is coming from is extremely important. And we mean like initially, they're going to be on all of these different platforms. But when they go to them, they're a different entity, if you will. They're operating a little bit different based on their normal social behavior. But when you're having a problem, you're in the midst of doing something, what is that person's initial behavior? It's to go to Google, or if they need to learn something in a visual way, they want to see a step-by-step of a how to do something. That's why YouTube is our pillar content, because we know you're coming to that search bar with a problem. And when you hit enter, we want to show up as one of your go-to resources that's going to solve that problem. That's why we don't have the skits and stuff so much so like we do on the Instagram Reels. We don't have that stuff baked into a YouTube video because we know you're coming frustrated, already having made mistakes or already having, you know, been frustrated with something. So when you click on something, you're very adamant about give me the answer right now. It's like feeding a person that's starving. They don't care about the Wagyu beef and how the cows get massaged and like just give me the slice of beef, please. And so that's why we treat YouTube more or less straightforward. And it depends on the what they're searching for and that what that video is going to produce. And then that next logical question as to where do you want to go for this? When somebody now finds us on social, either they're normally already on social or they're coming back of, let me see what else you have, because I also participate on this other platform. Are you there and how are you showing up there? And that's where they start to come in down through other funnels and stuff like that.
Got it. Thank you, Diana. So people have seen your content now. And then what I'd love to understand is, what are some of the systems that you have in place to make sure that you're generating leads for your coaching and client part of your business?
It's always about the next logical question. No matter where they're finding your content at, if they start on Instagram, if they start on TikTok, or if they start on YouTube, let's say if they're starting on YouTube, what's the next logical question? It may be that you need to go to video number two. That is the next logical question that you're having. Like, well, if I just figured this out, my next problem that I was thinking of or next question that I already had was to go to question number two. Then it may be question number three. On video number three, we may be talking about the duration of it. So here's a piece of the answer, or here is the answer. And a piece of this is coming out of maybe a PDF guide that we put together. Here's an image of it, some B-roll to show you what's inside. And if that is something that is desirable to you, usually it is at that point and where they are. And we've already solved so many of your other problems. It's an easy yes. So in psychology and selling, you go through what is called like that yes pattern. You want to get somebody to say, yep. Because it's like to help people get what they want, you have to give them what they want. Or help people get what you, or for you to get what you want, you have to help people get what they want. It's like a Zig Ziglar quote. So we still abide by all of those normal business entity type stuff, but it's just in the form of content. So that first video, yeah, I got you an answer, but if I try to sell you something or get you to download something, you're like, no, because I still have other problems. I'm not leaving. I still got other stuff to solve. So you really got to know where your people are coming from, where are they going, and what do they need along the way. Also, when it comes to micro content, when they find us there, how do we know where to give them something or whatever? Where is the intersection of the content, their problem, and that customer? So your content should be the intersection between the solution and the problem. Now, where are they though in that journey when they're encountering that specific problem? They may be at a place where you've answered, and now you can go ahead and sell them something or offer them something. And if they continue on, they'll run into another offer somewhere else along the road, which is fine, because the goal should be service-centered content, not self-centered content.
Yeah. So I do have two follow-up questions. So the first one is precisely on this, you know, get to the next, you know, logistical step, the next step. I get that from a term of content. But from a systematic point, do you also use emails? Are you grabbing them somewhere else? Are you taking them out of YouTube and bringing them up to a website? Or do you just get everybody just content, get somehow a direct conversion to coaching?
Yeah, so usually with the content, again, that next logical question, again, is based on where are they coming from and where are they trying to go to. So we'll always have where they can get up that premium free offer. So what are we currently offering right now? The Ultimate Guide to Live Streaming. So if we're talking about a bunch of live streaming content, if we're talking about a specific camera or whatever, there is some premium free offer that if you're enjoying these videos, if you're getting content out of what you're seeing, you'll really love this because we are able to go more in depth. You have a visual something, and then you also get on our email list where we provide additional information. Okay, that makes sense. But if it's a course, that's the next logical question. That's what we're pushing because we believe that's the next best thing for you. Now, how does somebody become a client? Because you answer their questions enough, they're like, I don't want the guide. I don't want this. I just need you because I recognize you can answer my questions in these free videos. I know that it'll be worth my time if I go to coaching. So sometimes, honestly, that post that we put out comes to a DM and it says, how can I hire you to help me in my YouTube business? Or it comes straight to an email where they go to the website and they see that form or whatever, contact me page populates. And it's like, what do you need help with? And they say, how do I hire you for coaching? It happens all the time. It literally is just a very simple process of pain point to solution in a very simple way. It may not be that like that for everybody, but at least it is for us.
Got it. And then one more follow-up question. Does it work similarly? A lot of our audience are affiliates. So I think for them, especially because you're talking about cameras and you're talking about things that entrepreneur needs overall, in your opinion, what works the best in order to increase affiliate revenue?
Make it very easy for people to get what you're saying. And if like, we'll link out what all the different things are. So if you just need the one thing, you can click on it, go to it and buy. But a lot of problems I see is that people introduce too many things before they just are able to check out, like stop with all the extra steps. If we're saying, here's the one microphone that we're talking about in this one video, or here's the setup and a PDF download guide for the full thing. If we link you to something to go buy it, it's usually to like our Amazon, influencer page. And it's the whole thing, the whole kit for the thing with that microphone included, the whole kit for the thing with the, you know, USB. So you'll see not just one answer, but other answers that maybe you haven't even asked yet. So when it comes to affiliates, we just make it real easy for people to check out. Like it's you want, you go buy. Anything else in the in-between, now leads them to backing out or leaving stuff in the cart, forgetting about it, need to think about it a little bit more. So if it's something that like we know that we're going to offer, it's like, what makes the most sense for them to get the most value out of this? If we're saying and talking about it, you've made a buying decision, you're at a yes now, the easiest thing is to make it easy for you to check out with no extra fluff in the middle.
That's so good. Yeah, it's just like a YouTube video. Like, don't talk about too many things, too many topics. Just talk about this one microphone, and here's how you can buy this one microphone. Love that.
Yep.
All right, Diana, let's talk about your sales process, right? So as a on the coaching and consulting side, so when somebody does DM you and they want to connect with you and they want to work with your agency, what does that experience look like for them?
Sure. So we're always about understanding, like, do they actually need to hire us for coaching, or do they just need something that we already offer that may be free? Now, I'm not for always just like, hey, come sign up. I'm trying to really understand, how can we best serve you? So when we get that message, we get that thing, the first thing that we're going to ask them is, what are you currently experiencing right now? We can definitely talk to you about coaching, but share with me a little bit more about what's actually going on. And if they start outlining problems around stuff with live streaming, it's like, you don't need coaching. Here's the video where we gave you every step that you're asking for. That's already in a free video, and we'll link them to that resource. So it's not always about making somebody sign up for coaching if it's something that we already offer. It's really just figuring out what problem are you actually having. Because sometimes they may be thinking that they can hire me to do something and I can help them with something, and I can't. Or I was like, I don't work with these kinds of organizations, so let me refer you to somebody else. So it's really about ushering them to where they actually need. Now, if it is where they actually, it makes sense for them to get started with us for coaching, we're very clear on next steps. What is the next thing that's gonna happen? So I'm gonna send you to this page, or we'll get you signed up for you to go to my calendar. When you enter your details, you'll pick the date and the time that is best for you, that's on our calendar. You'll go ahead and fund that specific, you know, event so that you can get it scheduled. You'll then get an email that will break down some additional details of what happens next. And before our call, you'll get an email. Like, I literally tell them everything that's going to happen, so that way they feel very comfortable about the next thing versus like, here's the page to go check out, have fun, and never hear from us until it's time for the call. I'm breaking down, here's what's going to happen next, because one, that also, like, that invisible barrier that happens about people being uncomfortable, like they do want to do business with you, but there's still some hesitancy at times there. So it's like, here's what's going to happen next. And literally just having the here's what's going to happen next flow and process in that conversation, even if it's a DM, repeating that again through email, makes them very comfortable. We've never had somebody cancel once somebody has scheduled a coaching call with us. We've never had that happen.
Yeah, that's really good advice. So when somebody does do that, are you open to like one call, or is it a minimum of like a certain like amount of time to work with you? How does that work?
So we offer initially just for them to purchase based on my calendar for availability. They can do a 30-minute session, or they can do a 1-hour session. I do offer like a coaching package where now you're talking about you really want to go in depth and build a channel. But most of the time, it's like people will have that one-off question, and I'm fine with just getting you that answer versus having you across 9 different sessions. And by session 2, it's like, well, what are we supposed to do for the other ones or whatever? Because those are specifically outlined to help them get to a specific end result goal. Well, I can't do that if you really only just needed one. So I offer those first. And that's if that is what makes sense. If they don't make sense for them, sometimes they'll get the 1-hour coaching session just to maybe ask some additional questions, get some right now pain points addressed. And then sometimes, a lot of times, people will just decide, you know what, I really want to go through, hire you for coaching and do the 9 session packages. Like, cool. Again, here's next steps. Here's how we get you signed up, and here's what's going to happen next when you check out or whatever. So that's something that only happens via communication. It doesn't happen like you can go get a link or whatever, because we want to make sure that it's right versus just like take a bunch of money from somebody and that's not what you really needed.
Got it.
Well, thank you so much. And thank you for allowing us to go deep. I know, especially with me, every question I had to be like a follow-up and another follow-up. So if people do want to follow up with you in that very, very same vein, I'd love for you to tell us a little bit more about your YouTube channel, where people can find you, and your website.
For sure. So you can always find me at dianagladney.com. And if you are on YouTube, if you put Diana Gladney in there, I will come up. But it's youtube.com/Diana Gladney. Instagram at Diana Gladney. Everywhere except Twitter, which is at Diana Gladney with the number 2, because I screwed up the first one.
Amazing. I hope you enjoyed that interview with Diana Gladney. If you did, please make sure to give this video a like and leave a comment down below. Check out the other interviews to learn more about growing your different revenue streams. And again, my name is Rob Balasabas with TubeBuddy. We'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.